Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding all the words in a moral panic written by Nitin Pai. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very, very important for public administration, political science and sociology optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the moral panics. This editorial is about how the people tend to participate, but that participation is inactive participation. Now, in order to understand this, we need to know about the difference between active participation and inactive participation. Now, as far as active participation is concerned, it is based on information, it is based on logic, it is based on analyzing the stuff, it is based on the complete engrossing that you have in your mind. On the other hand, we have inactive participation. Inactive participation is just for the sake of participating in a debate, discussion or discourse. This kind of participation is based on no information. This kind of participation is just kind of venting out your emotions. This kind of participation is a false participation. This kind of participation, it creates the moral panics in the society. Now, why do people participate? The people tend to participate for two purposes. The number one purpose is to enrich the debate, in order to enrich the discourse and to help the society move ahead in the civilizational process. On the other hand, we have some people who tend to participate in the debate, discussion and discourse, or they will come out or they will vent out their emotions for any event, for any news item, for any activity that is undergoing in our nation. Now, what is the purpose of the participation? How the participation can be made more engrossing? How it can be made more profound? How it can be made more enlightening and enriching? The basic purpose behind any debate is enrichment, and enrichment can take place only if one is aware of the complete thing. If one is aware of the entirety, if the one is aware of the holism, how can that be done? How can that be known? That can be done and that can be known if one is well read. If one imbibes the things that are happening in the society, try to recapitulate over them, try to think over them, try to understand them, try to integrate them with other aspects of the society. Just criticizing a policy, a program, a debate or an action of a government is not a right thing. The country expects the citizen to develop a scientific temper. This is explicitly mentioned in the Constitution of India. If you will not be developing a scientific temper, you will not be able to participate, which helps in enriching the nation. Now, on the other hand, this editorial highlights about how the people, they have been venting out their emotions on WhatsApp, on Facebook, on Twitter, and how the debates, seriousness of the debates has taken a backseat. How the people tend to take stand on each and every issue without being informed. Now, for the recent example, the people, they have been criticizing Arvind Kejriwal, or they have been criticizing Arun Jaitley without knowing the entire episode of this corruption that has unfolded in DDCA. And the same was the thing that the people had been criticizing Congress government, Congress party, sorry, for being party to National Herald corruption case. And 15 to 20 years back, 20 days back, people were criticizing the Chennai government for mishandling the floods. And 1 month before, people were criticizing the ISIS and how ISIS has been founded. People rarely knows about the complete thing. People will end up criticizing Mahatma Gandhi for letting Bhagat Singh die without knowing what had been given by Mahatma Gandhi to the nation. People will tend to criticize Jawaharlal Nehru without knowing about its positives, its negatives, and the work he has done. So this editorial actually is a kind of a message to the society, message to the civil services aspirants, to build up informed opinions, to build up informed logic, to build up informed sense, and only then to participate in debate, discussion, and discourse. Debate, discussion, and discourse is like a match. Before you participate in the match, it's important that you practice yourself. And practicing yourself is reading the stuff and thinking over that stuff and trying to integrate that stuff with whatever you have read before. Only then you will be able to build up your neutral and unbiased views. If you will not do this, you will end up having a stereotypical view of the society, a prejudiced and a biased view of the society, an aberrated view of the society. And if we will be having about millions of such views, it will not lead us to the right direction. See, on the spectrum, we have two ends. One end is a pure wrong. The other end is a pure right. The pure end and pure right and pure wrong, they exist only in theory. As far as the reality is concerned, reality is something in between this pure right and pure wrong. So we need to decode what is right, what is close to right, and what is close to wrong. Something that is close to right, we should be utilizing that, we should be using that, we should be nurturing that, we should be plowing that in order to cultivate the good for the humanity. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes or entire civil services preparation. And in order to avail the information of the classes that we're offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And in case you liked this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. And do participate in the answer writing program. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.